there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for me.
Hey, good morning, Braves. My name is Rob Smith. I used to teach and coach at St. John Bosco. Now I am a firefighter for LA County Fire Department. I work in Linwood at Fire Station 148. 9/11, on that morning, I was getting ready for work and my roommate at the time had the news on and they were showing clips of smoke coming out of the first tower. And as we were watching it, we saw the second plane hit. It was pretty traumatic seeing that live. We didn't really know what to think of it, but that day definitely changed the world. Something that I've learned in the fire service is that we have dedicated our profession to never forgetting the sacrifices that the firefighters as well as the police officers made that day. And as well, those that are in the military and the freedoms that they fight for us so that we're able to live our lives the way that we do here in America. Just want to give a shout out to all the fall sports and their coaches and players. Good luck this season. And hope all the students the very best in this school year. Guys, have a great day and go Braves.
I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. There was a time when you let me know what's really going on below.
Hello, my name is Matthew William Herrera. I am a senior at the United States Military Academy, West Point, St. John Bosco class of 2014. While I was at Bosco, I did what most high school students did, played sports, did theater. My senior year, I was student body president, and Mr. Torrey asked me to make this video about what 9/11 means to me and how that inspired me in my service. It's really quite simple. I remember as a kid watching on the news as the second plane hit the tower. And I don't really understand what's going on. You know, as a kindergartner, it's impossible to comprehend the stuff that's going on in the world. It's such a magnitude like that. The more that we look back, the more we reflect, the more that I've had the opportunity to see how that's impacted not just my life, but the lives of instructors here, coaches. It's changed so much. But the story of 9/11 isn't something, to me, it doesn't make me feel like there's a tremendous amount of evil in the world. Yes, there are evil people, but more importantly, there are hundreds of great people in the world who are willing to go into harm's way and do what needs to be done for every one or two people out there who seeks to hurt innocent life. And to me, that's the story of 9/11. It's not a tragedy. It's a reminder of who we are as Americans, looking out for our neighbors, taking care of one another. If I could offer you a piece of advice, I'd say this, that in trying times, we can never forget who we are as Americans, as Braves. We are united in our desire for peace. And if we seek peace, we have to be willing to do things that are difficult. We have to be willing to accept challenges, to push further, to demand greater. But we need to do these things with love. Love in our hearts and love in our eyes, love in our minds. Because love is the only solution to these problems. Only love will bring peace. So, love your neighbor. Thank you.